You talked about, you know, one of the Achilles heels of being able to transfer a bad play and leaving it behind. Mm-hmm. How have you worked on that? Like what is an example of something that helps you? Because I think not just in basketball, but even life, because I think that a lot of times with everything going on, 2020, COVID, people, situations, racially, socially, everything that's going on in our worlds, but just from a simplistic way, like, is there a tactic that you use? Like for me, for example, I find a spot in the stadium that I look at, mm-hmm. look at a spot, and I find a spot in every stadium, and I look at that one word or one thing, or it could be a blank wall, whatever it is, like, and I find that spot and I look at it, and it brings me back down to zero. It neutralizes me. It keeps me okay right here. No matter how good or how tough it's been, you know, some people I look at the foul pole in baseball. But like what, you know, Nomar Garcia Parr used to do his wrist and his gloves, you know. Have you ever used anything as you've been playing or even in life that has helped you?
Yeah. So it's really funny you say that, because as of probably 2, maybe 3 years ago, I've started to add meditation to just like my everyday. It's more so something I focus on when I'm in season. I find it really helps me just like calm my brain down a little bit, actually shut it off a little bit.
Yeah. That's what I need
so
to
it's really
do,
nice. Yeah. No, it helps for real. And something they teach, I just use the Headspace app, and something they teach is to kind of visualize and have that happy place. Right. So for you, it's what you find in the arena. So for me, what I found was I was always sitting and I had my hands crossed like this. And so there'll be times I've taken this with me where, God, I've never talked about this. There'll be times where I'm on the bench. Maybe it's right before the game is starting. So that maybe they're about to announce starting lineups. Maybe it's in a timeout, and I'll just kind of clasp my fingers, look down, and it kind of takes me back to that a little bit. Just like a calming situation. Yeah. The other thing is, though, before I found that, was, which I've also taken with me, and I would call this only the last like 5 or so years, like not that long. I just, you know, that inner voice, mm-hmm. I've finally figured out how to like get it to say, just be nice to yourself. Mm. Like, be kind to yourself. It's okay. Yeah, you had a turnover. It's okay. Just be kind to yourself. Because I felt like I was just beating myself up as I was a younger player, just getting really down and really almost like in search of a perfect game, knowing it doesn't exist, but still trying. And so now I'm just like, just be nice to yourself. And it's really helped me big time. Well,
I think that's a beautiful thing, because I think that, you know, I go to that image of you, you know, clasping your hands. And for me, I go to this image of this location that I was when my dad was on his deathbed, and I was a freshman in college, and I was playing NC State versus UNC. I'm taking you back now. I was NC State versus UNC. I'm sitting on a bench on my freshman year. My dad's on his deathbed, and I'm sitting there, and we're working these boys. Okay, just so you know, just we ain't supposed to beat these guys. They got everybody first round, everybody, and we're working these boys. Okay, and I'm sitting on the bench, and I remember looking up. I'm looking up in the top left corner of the stadium. And I remember sitting there, and everything got really calm. And I always say to myself, go to that place. Go to that place. And so I literally feel the bench again. I actually visualize the bench and everything getting calm again. And that's kind of me clasping my hands. That's my moment of, I'm here. And so you think about language and how significant language is. I started a company called Limitless Minds because I'm so obsessed with the mindset part of it, because the reality is that that's the one thing that we can control. Is our language, how we speak to ourselves, how we lead, how we communicate with others, how we overcome obstacles. Because the one thing that we do know is that we're going to face obstacles along the way. Right. No matter how big or little it may be, if you're trying to be great at anything, there's going to be obstacles along the way. And those challenges actually are what changes us. Those challenges actually are what optimizes us to become the best version of ourselves, I think. And so some people fear them. And I think the great ones, to look forward to them.
Yes.
And so I think that shifting your mind and that growth in your thought process and how you've been thinking about it over the past 5-6 years is actually really fascinating. And it's really cool, because it can be something so simplistic as you clasping your hands. It can be so simplistic as go to that place. Like, you know, and so I think that is a really critical part of remaining neutral and remaining that knowing that, hey, there's going to be obstacles along the way and everything else. And so, I mean, I guess that's what happens when you're the number one pick. you know, overall, you just, you know, you could, you're 2004, you know, you win your title, you're 2010, you win your second title, you win your third title, I think in 2018, and you win it again in 2020. I mean, four titles, and I'm trying to get to my second title.